There's a related question from Brett on Facebook I want to put to you. Brett, thank you for your question. Brett on Facebook is asking, would diversifying the police force be a better option? The police is 80% white. Maybe you can help us if that's actually true, Phillip. And he mentions the Title IX changed education in terms of diversification. So what do you say to that? We've seen that across some police departments, more of an effort to diversify. Is that part of the solution?
No. I wrote a piece called Community Policing is not the Answer, which is sort of similar around diversity and community relations. So there isn't much evidence to suggest that that changes the likelihood of police violence. In some cases, and if you talk to, this has been supported by different research, that, sometimes it's people from police officers from the same community can sometimes be as violent or even more violent for different sorts of reasons. And so it's one of those things where if you have a system that is fundamentally unjust, no matter who you put as an officer, they're going to reproduce the system in various ways. And if they don't do those things, it creates a context in which they won't, they'll be fired. And so, one way of sort of also thinking about this is that community policing and this focus on diversity emerges in the 70s on the heels of the urban rebellions of the 60s, at least 50% of which were prompted by instances of police violence. And this was a way of saying, we're going to put, diversity, and we're going to diversify, and we're going to focus on community police relations at the same time where the war on drugs devastated the lives of so many. And so every single time a high profile instance of police violence happens, community policing pops up as sort of the answer. And this has been decades, a decades long back and forth. And what we see now, for example, in Minneapolis, they had community policing. From what I remember, two of those officers were of color that killed George Floyd. And that did not stop George Floyd from being murdered because the system, and this is the focus.
You mean two of the other officers who were there, I just want to be clear, right? Who were on the scene.
There were four, yes. There was one in the front that was creating a perimeter, and I believe there were two that were also kneeling on him and restraining him from outside of the purview of the early videos. And so, for example, we take Minneapolis. They implemented pretty much all of the progressive reforms. They focused on officer diversity. They focused on community policing, procedural justice. They had early intervention systems for problem officers, implicit bias training, de-escalation,
all of the things we always hear about as possible reforms, right?
Because the focus on individuals and sort of these shifts do not speak to the broader structures. And so, again, the focus on diversity, it's not the answer, because in many situations, in many cases, we see that it can be police officers of all races, and it's because the structure is actually more important here than the focus on individual officers.